Excuse me. Last week, we defeated the Guardians and went to Terra, and then Kuja blew it up. Escape, and that's where we ended off. He's got a new airship. Technically, what we would do if we were continuing the story immediately was go to the Eva tree. There's some things worth checking in on. First, I think. I hope they're worth checking in on. Correct our potion supply. I don't remember where anything is in this city, so, oh, I don't think I needed to do that. Oh well. I don't want to do this. That's card game stuff. We won the tournament, we never have to think about cards again. Here? It's the upstairs of the auction house, I think. It's still not what I want. Okay, I think this is it. Yes. A couple of these I think we can return for rewards now. $5. Stuff. I need to find. I think I know where one. They both are now. Back here, Moogle. We got the auction house here. Which is the first place we're going. Or no, not the first. Yes, the first place we're going. Auction house is the first place we're going. Oh, man. Yes. Mini Sid. Fairy earrings. Promised ring. Right, we won our first item at the auction house. We got 50,000 gil to play with. Come on, guys. Hey. Promise ring. What you got? 40 seconds. Jesus. Apparently the promise ring is the real winner. $23,300. I mean, we can get money back real quick. Come on, let's go. Mm-hmm. Really, lady? This ring had better be worth it. Okay. What do we got? We got 20,000 gil left. Bet this goes for more than 20,000 and we don't win it. Thank you. Yep, and there it is. Nope. I think there are set prices. Well, I already have a promised ring, and it's fucking garbage. I don't know if dark matter would have been useful for anything anyways, but I think there's like predetermined amounts that the things sell for. I think. Maybe I'm making that up. Anyway, the third thing that we came to Treno for lies just in here. I doubt they're gonna have any weapons for us. We've got basically the strongest stuff we can have at the moment, I think. Excluding, like, depends on the character. Like, I don't think there are too many more that are more powerful for Don, for instance. Jesus. Apparently we're severely underleveled for that, I guess. Like, I don't think there is a. I think there's like maybe two more weapons that are more powerful than this one for Zidane. We obviously have much more powerful ones for him. I think we have much better for Ico here. But I really don't remember. I did look in the guide to see kind of like where weapons were, and I think like the next batch of powerful weapons that we can really get are in, like the final dungeon area. I did want to stop in Chocobo Forest, even though the last time I tried this I had absolutely zero luck with Chocobo hunting, item hunting. I think my Chocobo is just outside. Thank you. I also think you can find more powerful weapons through the the treasure hunting, maybe? But you have to find the map through this mini game. I found two treasure locations. And that's all the map I have been able to find. Most of my time playing this mini game when I was trying to do grinding and stuff went exactly like this. I found like three items maybe. And there doesn't seem to be any kind of rhyme or reason to where the things are. It's all just like completely fucking random, and it really sucks. Like, what is this horse shit? Clearly it's not very close if I'm getting the fucking PAHs everywhere in this location. Oh boy, Gaichel Glane. I need some anointment right now. Great, we found a fucking potion. Can't even carry any more of them. Alright, yep. So that's how my Chocobo Hot and Cold pretty much went when I was playing it to try and grind stuff to find treasures maps, to find treasures and maybe get some stuff that would be helpful, is I found fucking nothing. This minigame is garbage. Alright, well, this minigame sucks ass. I'm not gonna waste any more time with it. It's suck ass. I wanted to do a little bit of grinding first, and I forget where I need that. I think it's up here. This is what, our third Final Fantasy so far, and I gotta say, the side content in all of them has been pretty terrible. Yeah, I wouldn't count the one-off stream stuff. But yeah, type 0, 12, 9. For being PGs, which are in theory renowned for their side content, along with their main content, the side content in the Final Fantasies that we've played on stream at any rate has been pretty much trash. The fuck? Oh. Okay, well, If that dragon had done nothing other than attack Zidane, killing him over and over and over again, I was very seriously contemplating quitting tonight and playing something else. I still have the patience for that kind of bullshit. You can't even learn anything from the promised ring. That was a waste of a fucking pickup, man, let me tell you. There is not. Makes Vivi incredibly weak. Oh well, I feel like magic Elem Null will maybe be useful. Well, if I have magic element, I want to get Amaranth into the 40s. And I also wanted to have him learn. Oops, I used the fucking ether on the wrong person. God damn it. I want to have him learn more abilities so that way we don't have second weakest claws equipped anymore. Before we try and fight what's coming up. I meant to use the ether on Vivi. This party is better equipped for fighting this fucking dragon. Because when I was doing the grinding, I was fighting these dragons. With Garnet. No. Did I have Echo with me? Maybe? Oh, yeah, I had Echo with me. Like Garnet and Quinna and Steiner, and my god, was that ever a fucking hopeless party. The only one doing damage was Zidane. If he went down, we were pretty much fucked. Oh great, the one person I needed to not die. Wait. We are barely into this stream, and the game is severely testing my patience. What the fuck? Oh boy. Do I have there? As far as I know, there is very little I can do to prevent the game from being a gigantic piece of shit. I don't have Dragon Killer or anything like that. So I can't do more damage to it to try and avoid some of that absolute horse shit. Fucking useless. That's been useless. Let's get HP plus 20% here. Is that? Well, at least we got. Hey, we got a diamond out of that. It's completely fucking useless because I already have diamonds, but whatever. Aiko's almost got auto life now, and we can equip Amaret with a new weapon finally. I will teach him auto regen. Alright, now maybe Amaret will do a little bit more damage and we can kill this thing ever so slightly faster. I selected a pack with the wrong person. No, it was too busy killing Amaret this time to kill Zidane. Although it didn't kill him late enough in the battle to fuck over what I'm trying to do this time, so... This poison claw does so little damage to Vivi, but so much damage to Amaret. Alright, well, we've got auto life now. On Haiku. Doesn't have MP plus 20% equipped either. You should. I need to get 3 more. Let's do that one. She's not learning too many more abilities, and then I need to somehow come up with 12 for that. You know, it's probably a good thing I have Alert equipped, because the game would probably, in its never-ending quest to piss me off, give a fucking dragon a back attack on the party. Kill us all instantly. Check to see how far along Aaron was on learning his next ability. I think at least these next two that we have to learn are relatively low AP requirement. Fuck it, I'm just gonna use a tent, so it doesn't matter. Fuck outta here. Nine out of 20, okay. 35 for revive. 50 for... Okay. You know... Wow, cool. I needed to use chakra again, I... Oh, Vivi, to get more MP, oh well. You know, they announced they're making an Octopath Traveler 2. What a waste of time and money making that game is. Yes, Triangle Strategy is coming to PC. I have a Switch, so I could have just bought it on the Switch. I might get it on the PC, I might get it on the Switch, I don't know. The main reason I haven't gotten it yet, at any rate, is because there are so many other JRPGs I'd rather play. Or at least I thought there were so many other JRPGs I would rather play. That was me foolishly thinking that I would like Live Alive. That I would like. I would want to go back to Octopath Traveler for more than a few seconds to find out that nope, it's still. Still bad. There's also a brief period of time where I tried to play Bravely Default 2. That's a fucking nightmare of a game, too. The grinding that I'm doing now, Bravely Default 2 was expecting me to do like 10 minutes into the game, basically. And fuck that. Because the leveling up was even fucking slower than this game. Well, I guess actually the leveling up is really fast in this game. So the leveling up was a fucking snail's pace compared to this game. You level up pretty goddamn quickly. It's one of the few positives about this game that's not the main story, basically. Said the few positives about the game, but I like the story, I like the characters. The bosses are getting ridiculous, and I don't know, you level up quickly at least, but you shouldn't have to grind. I think it's a failing of the game's design if you have to go out of your way to level up for main stuff, basically. And And old school RPGs are chock full of that. I think, maybe I'm wrong, I think other older games had at least interesting side stuff to do that you could kind of carry along with. But man, the side stuff in this game is fucking miserable. We can't have people finishing the game in a reasonable length of time. No, 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 no. That just won't do, no sir. That's the reason why the difficulty in the original US release of Devil May Cry 3 is fucked. Is because Capcom didn't want the people finishing the game too quickly. Ended up really shooting themselves in the foot with that one. And I found this out recently, it's a terrible game regardless, but they did the same thing with Mega Man X3, actually. For the US release of X7, Mega Man X7, they have the damage that you do in that game for the US release only. Because they didn't want people finishing the game too quickly. X7 is overall just a shit of a game. But man, why does that do so fucking much damage to Zidane? Level 40 now. Okay, he needs 35 points. Thank you. Right, maybe if we give Don something. I mean, he can learn ability up, I guess. I guess we'll learn auto-floating mini. He's got that already. Alright, we can maybe do something helpful. Sure, we'll teach Vivi auto-haste. Finish this off. Let's go to where that works. Is it best to get on? I think it'll be interesting to see what, if any, Final Fantasies have actual good side content. Final Fantasy 16, some of the side content was okay, and I guess. Now, let's see who and how he's doing attack wise. Final Fantasy 13 doesn't really have side content. Some of the stuff in Final Fantasy X not being too bad. I don't remember any of the side content in like 8 or 7 being all that thrilling. I remember enjoying Blitzball when I played Final Fantasy X back in the day. this motherfucker again. Fucking kidding me, the only thing this thing is good for is AP. The game fucks me over once again. It's okay for money too, but fucking seriously, what the fuck is with this game? I like it deliberately targets the character that you're trying to do anything with. Cares about my treasure hunt rank, which will never increase because the video game will not give me any treasure maps. Fucking piece of shit. That is absolutely fucking useless. Ico and Dagger don't have fucking lightning attacks. If you count a summon, which I wouldn't. Fucking trash. Okay, we can do that. Ultima Sword. Holy Lance, which we already have one of. Ender, which we already have. Kaiser Knuckles that we don't have. Alright, this is just the store. We can just straight up buy the Ultima Sword here. Cool. Dragon Risk. Power Risk. Shadow element attack. Alright, let's just get this out of the way. We have a defender. We'll buy Ultima for Steiner. One of those. We'll get some Kaiser Knuckles. Someone else has better sword. We technically have a dragon rest. Who the fuck has one equipped? Amarant does. Huh, okay. Get two more of these. We'll get two of these. And then we're out of cash. Cool. Once we can equip, once we've learned Revive and we can equip the Avenger, we will move on. Oh man, I wish I would have known this. We could have moved on from Poison Knuckle or Mithril Claws so much sooner, because we could just learn Curse from the Kaiser Knuckles. I think before all is said and done, I'm gonna have to do some grinding with the other party members, get them up to speed, because I think part of the, like, final battle may force you to use them. That's what it seemed like. I don't know how accurate that is. Or if they just give you the opportunity to change your party mid-final battle and the guide was just switching people up for some fucking reason. Fuck off. Goddamn cat begging for food. Well, dragon's fucked. It should be dead, I'm pretty sure. Dragons only have like 10,000 something HP, HP. Maybe my memory is wrong on that. Bastards. I'm not giving it my diamond. They're my diamonds. The cat can fuck off. That's what the cat can do. Attack that hits Amaranth or Zidane is probably gonna send him into trance. That's totally gonna be wasted against one of these fucking dragons. Yeah. Speaking of, there's no point in using those. Fucking damage. Never understand how I had the patience for this as a child. I was the significantly less patient person as a young child. As a youngster, when I would have been playing this, I would have been a significantly less patient person. Although I never did beat the game. I never finished it. I got to disc 4 and then never finished it, so... Activation rate, huh? Poison seems to be doing Amaranth in quite a bit, so let's give him antibodies. I also need to get... I do remember this much, I need to get equipment that makes me... If not fully immune to wind, but... taking less damage from wind. I should see what I have already. Water, fire, rebirth, shadow, spirit, thunder. Fire, thunder, water damage by half. Thunder only. I don't seem to have anything with wind attack. Absorbs wind, water, wind. Fire, ice, thunder, holy damage reduced by 50%. I don't think I can easily get more ribbons, unfortunately. Let's see if any of the stuff that this dude sells would help Ice. Shadow attack. Wind by 100%. We're gonna have to grab a couple of these. I have 0. Still a bit off, but it helps to prepare ahead of time. Apparently the buff that's coming up uses a lot of wind elemental shit. Some Azura's Wrath earlier, and Like, that game sucks. Playing that definitely didn't put me in a good mood. I had to work today. Work doesn't put me in a good mood these days. Are you fucking kidding me? Fuck off. Taking damage fills up the transmitter. When you take enough damage, you trance. It's impossible to control as a ability, because you can't stock it up for later like you can with other ultimate type abilities. Like in Final Fantasy VII, you can avoid using your limit breaks. I think that was also true in Final Fantasy VIII. It was definitely true in Final Fantasy X. You didn't have to use your overdrive or whatever it was called right away. Half of my strategy for dealing with the, like, end of Final Fantasy X was to just get everyone, fight random battles until everyone's overdrive was charged, and then as soon as I got into the boss fight, unleash everyone's overdrive. Get all of Yuna's summons overdrived as well, because late game bosses in Final Fantasy X would kill summon instantly. They all had like a special ability that would take them out in one turn. So you'd get one turn with the summon, so you better just use it for overdrive or whatever the hell it was called. But in this game, trance is fucking useless pretty much. Oh sure, now it misses. Bastard. It also charges slowly in this game, whereas I recall it charging much faster in Limit Breaks, charging much faster in 7. Alright, two more fights will do it. And we can go die on the Ipa tree. That's mighty optimistic of you, Bargu, to think that I would live. Well, whatever, it gives 3 AP, so we'll just kill the stupid cat and move on with our lives. Alright, let's equip the Avenger. I don't think we want elemental attack wind anyways, so. No, it's the hat. Who? Heal up. There was a save move here, wasn't there? Yes, there is. Now we go die on the Ica tree. Ica tree, whatever, however you pronounce it. Let's enter. That is a lot of dragons. Hey, the Lindblom military is here. Lose those dragons. Nothing, don't worry about it, Dagger. You know you're at the climactic finale when all the friends you made along the way show up. Oh hey, a dragon. What do you know? Boy, I stole a dragon rest off of it. Alright, let's see if Lazaga does. Oh, that was rude. Grand Dragons seem to take more damage from ice. Seems to be the way to go. Good thing I read ahead, so I knew to have anti-wind, so this dragon wouldn't have, like, instantly killed me. It's the, sword nose, red highlights dragon, the shitty Yu-Gi-Oh card that no one ever talks about. Like 50,000 HP or something like that. I'm just gonna have Zidane start attacking. Well, fuck me. If one of these attacks kills this dragon, I am gonna be pissed. Well, cut that one a little close with the whole reviving Amorous thing. I mean, we've exited the ship a bunch of times, so. Oh, don't worry, there are still more bosses to come. Yeah, maybe you're just losing it, Zidane. He said you were the only person that he was talking to. He said that. This is the crew. Don't even have save Moogles here. What is this garbage? Right, I will be right back. All right, who's ready to revisit our memories? Fought whatever the hell this thing is supposed to be. The nice thing about this party composition is that I have two people that can cast high-level revive spells effectively. that's a real dick move. He's already fucking virused up, and now you freeze him in ice. Hate that. Oh wait, he has auto life, that's right. Fuck balls. Waiting for it to kill the Don. Alright. Nope, didn't kill him this time for whatever reason. Horrible inconsistency in the way things are coded, maybe? I don't know if they fixed it for the Pixel Remaster version that we will eventually be playing. But some of the stats in Final Fantasy VI are completely broken, so that's fun. If you make it to this area, Memoria, with under 12 minutes, fuck up. Our game can go fuck itself. You get the Excalibur 2 weapon. I think it's Memoria that you have to get to. I don't think there's another. That's because the card game blows. We'll be right back. Yeah, I don't really have many coins. There's a card game in Final Fantasy VIII as well, although I remember it being a little better than the one in this. Like it actually makes sense. It isn't just completely and totally unexplained like the card game in this one. Alright, well, we've killed Iron Man and stopped the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Since the game we're playing is from 2000, then technically this would even be before MCU Phase 1 occurred. Why did Amaranth die? What? Oh, video game. Oh, I probably shouldn't be using fire against this game then. Would have been cool if he used the flame sword before. his reflect lasts so much longer than ours. Alright, let's see if the video game will let me do something this time. You know, if I were psychic, I would have known ahead of time that there was a boss that used fire and would have prepared even more for this. This is actually something that has been annoying me about a lot of the RPGs I've been playing lately, is they kind of expect you to just know what's gonna happen ahead of time so you don't get your ass kicked. And it sucks. I have no idea what the fuck that ability is, it just kills people instantly. But it is fucking bullshit. Nope. Well, fuck me. Fuck this. If I would have known ahead of time this was how this fight was gonna go, I would have brought a third physical attacker. That way I could actually hit once in a great while. At least all those focuses paid off, so we did almost 10,000 damage. If this were, like, Octopath Traveler, this boss would have, like, 100,000 health or some bullshit, and we'd be doing, like, 5 damage to it. Oh, fuck me! Cool. And now, are you fucking kidding me? The fuck is that? Fucking horse shit. Oh. That is fucking bullshit. Motherfucker! If I die to this boss, we are never coming back to Final Fantasy IX. I will find something new to play on Friday. What do you mean with this fucking horse shit? Fucking broken ass game. I don't know, and we may never find out. So we're pausing, alright. I'm going back to the save point and... Here. This is just a regular ass enemy in this location. You better not fight that boss again. I'm already debating if I even want to come back to this game next week. That's it for tonight.